It's the Joe Padula Show, Clarksville's conversation.
Absolutely.
Hey, what is the Caren Act, and will it prevent people from calling 911 on black people? Yeah, those answers are now on the Joe Padula Show. Absolutely. Make sure to subscribe, click like, leave your comments, and definitely help us out and share this video now. We could use the support of the spread of the word.
Spread
them. Gloria Wayne, have you heard of this Caren Act?
I have.
Yeah.
Yes. Because you sent it to me earlier today.
Is it crazy?
It is.
Did you get a chance to look at it?
I did get a chance, yes.
This is weird, man. This is weird. All right, so...
I love these acronyms. Your law's not good unless it's got a good name that's a good acronym. And this has one.
Yeah.
Can this one be C-A-R-E-N?
This one is C-A-R-E-N.
Yes.
Not Caren as
not
in...
Caren with a K.
But it's obviously going for that Caren word.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
It's called the... the caution against racially and exploitative non-emergencies, okay, which Caren.
Okay.
Right.
Which would, what they're saying, would outlaw racially motivated 911 calls.
I love the motivation, but I think they probably could have done better on the acronym.
It's definitely a moniker for Caren, but yeah.
You know, if they wanted to go with the K, they could have started with, like, keeping Americans really
epically nice,
excited.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why they went with C.
Anyone besides Lawyer Wayne, can you guess what city this is coming out of?
California.
What city? Looking for a city.
San Francisco.
Very good. San
really?
Francisco. Of course it is.
Oh my gosh, that was a total guess.
Of course it's coming out of San Francisco. Either that or Portland. This is nonsense. But maybe it's not nonsense. Maybe this holds water some way, somehow.
I like the motivation,
though.
I like it.
So San Francisco Board of Supervisors, okay? One of the members, Shaman Walton, introduced a legislation. This was back in July, okay, when they introduced it. And so since July, it has recently been passed. And it was in response to a rising incidence of people harassing, quote-unquote, in response to the rising incidence of people harassing and calling 911 on black people and people of color doing daily activities all over the country. Karens. Okay.
That's horrible. You can't even keep a straight face with this. It's a great act, but how do you keep a straight face?
So the Caren Act... We'll make it illegal. This is from the one who proposed it. The Caren Act will make it illegal for people to contact law enforcement solely to discriminate on the basis of a person's race, ethnicity, religious affiliation, gender, sexual orientation, or gender identity, and other protected classes of ethnicity, religious affiliation, gender, sexual orientation, or gender identity. Nobody's calling 911. Hey, somebody's Jewish.
My neighbor's gay.
Right.
Get out here quick. Isn't that already a thing, though? Like, I mean, you're not supposed to discriminate.
Yes. It's already illegal to falsely report a crime.
This feels redundant.
This city has, like, massive loads of homeless poop and urine in its streets, and this is what they're focusing on? So under the Caren Act, individuals who make fraudulent 911 calls can be sued, okay, by those who were harmed for damages.
You can already do that.
That's
right?
Already a thing.
Up to $1,000.
I don't have
Why
to be
Why would they cap
Wayne
it at $1,000? Why not actual damages? If you call in a false police report, you know, it's called swatting.
Okay.
Right? That's the classic thing. You call in a false police report and say, oh, man, Lawyer Wayne's got a bunch of kids locked in his basement. He's going to kill them all with bombs. Y'all better raid his house. And they come in and they shoot me and I die. Right? You better believe you're going to get sued the heck out of that.
For more than $100.
For more than $1,000. I'm worth more than that.
Like at least $1,000 per kid.
Yeah. I mean. So calling in a false police report, you know, the idea that you need a special law to allow you to sue them and that it's capped at $1,000, that's
counterproductive.
It's kind of weird.
Because you can currently sue them, like Gloria Wayne said, and you can sue them for damages. So honestly, it almost sounds like they're working against the citizen or the victim, because now it's not like, oh, I can get real damages, 10, 20 grand. Now they're saying, oh, you know, we'll throw you a grand.
What if you have to give a description?
What do you mean?
You're making a 911 call.
Right.
You have to give a description.
That's kind
I refuse.
Oh. Hey, yeah, oh my God, I'm being robbed. There's this white guy coming. Oh,
I see a man breaking into a house. Right. I mean a person.
How do you know if it's...
Can't say it's a man.
Right.
Gender-based language.
Hey, what do you make of all this?
You don't know what they identify as.
I would never date a girl named Caren.
Yeah, okay. Right. Right. It's just not happening. Right.
Glad that's the takeaway.
With a C or a K, yeah. Either way.
Yeah. You won't be doing no Caren Act, right? No, yeah, no, absolutely.
No, sir. Absolutely.
It's just a waste of time. It's just a waste of time.
It's one of those bills that you introduce so you can get a little news story written about you as the local politician, and you get to go around and say, "Hi, I made the
Caren Act."
And you know, you get
but I really
proud
see this
sponsor of the Caren Act.
This could really end up having reverse results in people that oh my God, I'm being attacked, and now. Without flying off the cuff, here's the 5 W's, who, what, when, where, why, get here soon. You're going to have people wanting to, you know, what do they call it, walk on eggshells when reporting a 911 call. Yeah.
Could be. Crying. As if people actually cared about what the law says.
This is true.
Well, if they get fined. Because this guy, the one who introduced it, wants to make it effective.
It's already a felony, though. Yeah. I mean, you can go to jail for false reporting.
If you're already calling in a false report, why do you care about the fact that they might be able to sue you for $1,000, right? You've already made that choice.
Yeah.
So you saying is that going to override what's already in place, or is this
right?
I know what Tennessee law is. I don't know
what is it in Tennessee.
If filing a false report's a felony.
Yeah.
Right. Abuse of a 911 system is a misdemeanor already, punishable by fines, jail, and obviously if someone, as I said, if someone files a false report or calls 911 on you for, you know, for malicious purposes, whether it's racially motivated or not doesn't matter. You can still sue them.
Caren.
I know down in Florida, we got fined by the police department because our alarm kept going off on our business. And it went off. They told us on the second time, they said, if it goes off again and there's nothing going on, you're going to get fined. And yeah, we got fined $500 by Orange County Sheriff's Department.
Because it's a non-emergency pool of resources.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And it had to come out.
The kind of law that this is here for is, it's troubling because what it tries to do is create what they call a protected class of people, right? Mm-hmm. If you have a law that says, if I punch you, the punishment is this, but if I punch you because you're black, then you get then the punishment is extra.
Now it's a hate crime.
The feature of that is we want to stop people from doing bad things because of bad reasons, but it's condescending to the so-called protective classes, as if they can't, Jews can't handle their own business, so they need a special law to protect them against, you know, religiously motivated phone calls or something like that.
The only way I agree with what you're referring to with protected class is when it comes to the elderly or children.
But that's...
Like, that's if you look at elder abuse, that's...
Child abuse has its own law, and I get that, right? It is worse to commit a crime against a child, but it's because of the nature of the child, not the nature of the actor, right?
Well, that's what I'm with the elderly. I'm thinking it's similar to that of a child because they're helpless. Maybe they
actually
can't defend themselves.
See, that's the thing. They actually need protection.
Correct.
If I say, look, I need extra punishments for people that attack me because I'm Jewish, it's not really true.
Yeah.
I think this just stays in San Francisco. Maybe you'll see the Caren Acts in like Portland or Seattle, stuff like that.
I think it's going to be great meme material. It's just meme material. That's what it is.
Bay, what do you make of it?
Crazy.
That's it. That's the only word. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's a waste of taxpayers' dollars. But hey, it's San Francisco.
Just like
they
that
waste their tax dollars all the time.
Wouldn't happen under Kamala Biden.
The Kamala Biden ticket.
Partner.
It's the Joe Padula Show. Bada bing. Clarksville's conversation.